Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to Jurassic World Minecraft. In today's video, we're going to start work on the hybrids for the very first time. We're going to try to make a whole bunch of those interesting new hybrids, including the Indominus Rex. And we're also going to do a little bit of exploration because we found a couple of pretty cool things. So, let's kick things off by heading... Oh, there we go. I was wondering where the music was. Copyright strike. Let's head into the Innovation Center and over towards the lab. I'm just going to go inside you, Mr. Apatosaurus, if that's okay. Now, I've been exploring. I've managed to get all but one of the dino DNAs, and it's really frustrating me. I will show you exactly what I'm missing. These are really cool, by the way. These are like actually animated. Look at these. That's Mr. DNA. Dino DNA. That wasn't great, but it is about the only accent I can do. So, as you see, these were all full. These were all full. We got the Tyrannosaurus Rex. I've got that from the Amber Mines. Yes, it was a pain in the ass. This is the only one I don't have, and I believe it's the Gallimimus, actually. I can't see Gallimimus anywhere else on this list. So I'm pretty sure the one I'm missing is Gallimimus. Of all the dinosaurs to be missing, it's the Galli bloody Mimus. So if you know where to get Gallimimus, please do let me know. I did already get the one from Gallimimus Valley, but maybe there's another one there that I missed. Anyways, let's make some pretty cool hybrids. I'm excited about this. So, first thing we need to do, how do hybrids work in terms of the colours? Because we've seen with these ones, we can bring in cuttlefish, we can bring in tree frog, and we get some variation in the colours. We got colourful and we got bioluminescent. For the hybrids, how does this work? Okay, so hybrids do not have the same idea, seemingly, right? Okay, we're gonna make some hybrids. So, we're gonna make all of them. Sound like plan? Sounds like plan. We need red velociraptor, red T-Rex, and red cuttlefish. This might be a slightly slow process. Hey, where's my vials? I need many more vials. Game? Game, I need more vials. Many more vials. Oh! I got it! I just talked! Oh, it's because I didn't do the tutorial the second time around. Because, you know, I'd already done it before and I actually reloaded the save after the very first time we did this. And because I'd already done it before, I didn't follow the tutorial because I knew what to do. And there we go! We've got all the dinosaurs. Awesome. Alright then. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, cool. Right. Sweet. Magical egg things are happening. Love me a magical egg thing. It's on fire, but that's okay. That's science. Let the science happen to you folks. And there we have an Indoraptor egg. And if we go over here now, we're not gonna hatch it. We're gonna hatch it in an actual enclosure like intelligent people. We should somewhere in here have... That's our bioluminescence. So where's the Indoraptor at? Shut up! My god. I don't know. Maybe it's because I've not hatched it yet. That could be it. I think we may have to hatch it first. Yeah, we do. So what I'm going to do, because this will take a long time, I'm going to go make every single hybrid right now. I'm going to get the eggs for all of them. And then what we'll do today is we're going to test out all of these different hybrids. And then I'm going to show you something pretty cool as well at the end. Okay, about 20 minutes later, that's how long it took to pull this off. If we head over to this little box doohickey over here and have a look in, there we go, folks. 11 different brand new hybrid dinosaurs, only two of which we've ever seen before in the Indominus and the Indoraptor. I'm wondering if some of them are from toy lines or maybe from Jurassic World the game, Jurassic World Live, stuff like that. But if they are, it's all news to me. So we have the Indoraptor, the Indominus Rex, the Stiggy Liberi, the Simacosophus, the Omega Rex, the Claridon, the Venatorus, the Plumaraptor, the Placidosaur, the Phasinonathus, and the Iacosaurus. Lots and lots. I'm just going to get them away from my inventory just before I accidentally put down an Indoraptor. You can even see on the Indominus, look, you can see him. The little white skin poking through there, and the Indoraptor's got the black one. Very, very cool. Now. We need to find a place for most of these. All the herbivores we're going to put together, like I say, in like a little hybrid. What on earth is... What are you two up to? What is this? I don't even want to know. I'm leaving. So, we need to find a suitable habitat. We have a perfect one for the Indominus Rex. I think we should go check that out first. So, folks, what could be better for showing off our brand new Indominus Rex than the actual Indominus Rex paddock from Jurassic World? I unironically had no idea this existed until today when I was just moving around and I found it. I'll show you where it is on the brochure. We're kind of like way at the northern reaches. There's Mount Sebo, actually, just there in front of us. Mount Sebo does something a little special. We'll be doing that in the final episode, so keep an eye out for that. But, well, I'm sure you can guess what it is. But yeah, this is the Indominus Rex paddock. Here is Tool Guy, but Tool Guy, we're going to pretend that Tool Guy is the guy who gets eaten by the Indom. Here's the big old the crane nearby, probably the car that they actually duck under here, and Owen covers himself in the fuel. Let's see if we can actually get inside. Oh, very cool. Okay, oh, is that a timer? No, okay. Hey, really? Right. So I wonder if I can run forward, click the button. No, okay. All right, let's leave that open, shall we? We're not having a repeat of last bloody time. Right, hey, look at this. Isn't this awesome? And there's an InGen scientist over there. We'll have to go talk to him. Maybe he'll tell us about the Indominus Rex. But really, if you're going to put the Indominus Rex anywhere, where better than here? So, our very first hybrid. Very exciting. Indominus Rex egg. You ready? Wait. We should shut this. I'm going to head through that gate over there instead. We're not having a repeat of the bloody film. Right, here we go. And there it is, looking absolutely freaking terrifying. It looks like an old man despite being a baby. I love it. Hey, buddy. Wait, do you want food? Can I feed you now? Will you like me? I know you're not trainable. Well, oh. I mean, you seem to... I mean, you ate all my beef. That's something. Oh, okay. Well, there's the Indominus Rex. Very cool. I want to show you it when it's fully grown. So let's hop inside here. We're going to talk to the InGen scientist. And then we'll hopefully just hang around for a little bit and he'll get it. Bloody Nora. They get big quick, so... Hello, InGen scientist. We are doing research on designer dinosaurs. Dinosaurs. Our latest recipe is larger than we expected and extremely dangerous. It even kills its own siblings. You can create it with free... Well, there's the details on how we created it already earlier on in the video. What are these? I have no idea. So this is actually the little scene where, you know, Claire and Masrani are standing up against the glass. One of the best posters for Jurassic World has Claire right up against the glass, and you can see the snout of the Indominus Rex on the other side. It's very cool, and here we are. I love that. Right, I will kill some time for a little bit until it decides it wants to eat me, basically. So it's big enough to eat me. Where's it gone? How cool would it be if it had the camouflage, basically? I know we... Yeah, but it seems unlikely, but still. It would be very cool. Whoa! I didn't see it for ages, and then... Well, I found it. Hey! Do you want to get down off that tree, maybe? Do you want me to... I'm going to help you out, buddy, okay? The deal is, I'm going to help you out. You're not going to eat me, okay? I suspect he does not have the same deal. Get you out of there, pal. Gonna get you out of there. Just give me a minute, alright? There we go. Yeah. Need another log. It's lacking the terrifying beginning that I was... Oh! Sorry, buddy. Sorry. I only punched you a little bit. Don't worry about it. Oh, God. Oh, the humanity. Jesus Christ, that is loud. I'm just gonna go ahead and turn my headset down a little bit. Bloody Nora. Gonna get him off there. Slowly but surely. Oh! There we go! Is he out? Let me get him off this little thing as well. There we go. Now, I hope you've forgiven the many punches. It is worth remembering. Get your head out of the bloody... Come here. Oi. Okay. I don't know what to do about this one. He's not that interested. He's kind of got his own... There he goes. There you go, folks. There's a good look at the Indominus Rex. Very cool. I wonder why he's not interested in eating me. Maybe I can't control him and tame him completely, but maybe we... like a little bit did, you know, just feeding him when he was younger. Maybe that was enough to make him not want to rip me apart. Maybe. I'm going to come check on you later, buddy, if that's all right. And we'll see if you've decided to stop sticking your head in the wall. Seems unlikely. Right! Run. I was hoping for a nice dramatic exit, but unfortunately, he's not that interested. So, before we head off and try out our other hybrids, there's something I want to show you guys. So for the last few videos, I've mentioned a few times now that what I really want to do is hunt down the old visitor center from Jurassic Park. That was high up on my list. And I had a few people tell me that they couldn't find it. It was really hard to find. And a lot of people said it doesn't actually exist because they just simply couldn't find it. Well, worry no more, folks, because if we turn around dramatically, there it is. There is the old visitor center, if you want to find it on the map. And it is tricky to see if you're flying around, for example. You probably can't see it because it's in all the trees. But it's about here. It's just to the northwest of the main part of the park. If you just go to exactly where I am on the map right now and you look up, you'll see this beautiful bad boy. Now, I've not been inside. I found it and I thought we should enjoy this together as a YouTube community and other soppy rubbish. So, it was just a terrifying noise at my window and I have no idea what it was. Right, let's go inside. Oh. It actually is the old visitor center. The T-Rex obviously has been knocked down and stuff like that, but The staircase up here, this is where, you know, we see Lex and Tim for the first time. Hammond's walking up and they... Grandpa! Oh, God. He takes a tumble. Breaks a hip. He doesn't take a tumble. There's that... Oh, this is the restaurant. Let's go down here first. This is the restaurant. Oh, it's actually the old visitor center. That is amazing. It's actually making me so happy. I wonder if we can get into the kitchens as well. Yes! Look, it's the kitchen from the film! Wait, where's the freezer? Is this a freezer? No. The freezer should be here, right? They haven't included the freezer. Boo! Okay, but still, this is the kitchen where Lex and Tim, of course, are hiding from the Velociraptor. Oh, maybe this is the freezer. This is the freezer! Wait, I need to recreate it. Door gets slammed. That's the best I can do, I'm sorry. Oh, that's amazing. I'm actually, honestly, this DLC blows my mind. It really does. A lot of people kind of memed it when it first came out, because I don't think we expected much, but it has been consistently incredible stuff. I wonder if we can get to... Hello? Oh, that must be someone at the monorail station. Okay, I'm wondering if we can go to the, like, the old lab or something. Oh my god, we got the... Oh, we've got the DNA tour. You know, you sit down here and it kind of like rotates around. Very cool. Mr. DNA pops up and tells you about dino DNA. Any excuse really, folks? Looks like this is the backdrop to it. Weird door. This is the lab. I think, if I remember the formation correctly, so there should be like a little mini room here, which I guess this is the point of the this bit where there would be... I built this in Minecraft myself a long time ago. I remember building there's a little mini room here and that's where the camera is. So Dennis Nedry is standing like... See, this doesn't match, but the rest of it does. Where's this? Oh, whatever. Oh, I swear I just saw fire burning over there. Well, other than the fact that the lab isn't here, let's just pretend this is it. So I remember building this security camera there. Dennis Nedry kind of stands here. He's looking at his watch. He's timing it. Camera shuts off. He charges in. And then in here, this kind of circular, it would be more rounded if it wasn't Minecraft, glassing. And this is in the middle would be where the old DNA tubes are. You know, the DNA canisters where he loads them into the barbasol can. I am really impressed that they've done this. This is a super cool. Ooh, button. Yo! Right, okay, I think this is actually meant to be the old control room, right here. But this, look. We can go up into the vents. You remember when they're trying to escape from the raptors towards the end of the film? And Lex and Tim are like, and well, the whole gang basically is crawling through the air vents to get away from the raptors. We even have that bit. And look, this one's fallen through because this will be where Lex falls through the air vent a little bit for the ceiling thingamajiggy, and the raptor bites up at her. Go back and watch that. If you've never seen it, by the way, go back and watch that scene and look at Lex's face. There was a problem with her face basically during that scene, so they had to superimpose her face back over the top of it, and it is painfully obvious. It's immediately noticeable. It looks very, very strange. Cool to find the garage, basically. We could also turn this into a pretty cool and there we go. And there's the two cars they were working on. Well, they were working on one of them. Look at that! Oh, it's the night vision binocs. Awesome. Okay, I think that's the end of it, but that is, yeah, I'm very happy. Right, let's go play with some more hybrids. So my problem at the moment is that we're kind of low on exhibit space. I have made all seven of the quick builds, by the way. It took bloody ages to find them all, but I did manage to do it. But I think only four of them are exhibits. So Liddy, and I'm sure this could only go really well, you're gonna share with the Indoraptor, okay? We've seen how this went down in the film and everything was fine, so here we go. Yo. That's awesome looking. Look at that. It's got the proper, the animation, the body shape, the kind of like alien-esque kind of thing. You know what I mean? Look at it go. Oh, I love that. Very cool. Very cool. Meh. Right, you and Liddy. Liddy. I know you're not like trained anymore, Liddy. I think it's because I captured her, by the way, and like moved her in the crate. We probably just have to lead her here the normal way, or have it just follow us around forever, I suppose. But the point is, Liddy is going to be very chill, and we're not going to fight, are we? No. Oh. Oh no. Oh no. Instantly. Instantly, he went to try to. Liddy! Liddy, run! Run, Liddy! Liddy, you are tiny compared to this thing. Right, we need to help. We need to help. Liddy, no! Bloody hell. You're right, girl. We'll find somewhere else for the Indoraptor. It's gonna be okay, Lids. It's gonna be okay. We'll release it on the public. It'll be okay. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Stay there, okay? Stay. Good raptor. Right, so that's the Indominus Rex and the Indoraptor. All the others are gonna be a little bit funkier. So what I think I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go put them all down. I'm having to wait for ages for them to grow up each time. It's kind of boring the life out of me. So I'm gonna go put them all down. No, I can't do that. Okay, never mind. I will wait. I am patient. I'm a good boy. So we've come over to the custom built aviary. So this is currently completely empty. This is a quick build, as you can see from quick build G over here. This is our quick build G. He does aviaries and training centers. And this is going to let us put down, I do believe one of these is a flyer. I think, I don't remember which. Actually, I think it's Claridon. I think Claridon, and it does look like one, is a flying creature. So shut these on the way in. I think that's a good idea. And so this is our first brand new hybrid. Let's take a quick little look at it and find out what it is. Claridon, Dimorphodon, Tropical Bird, and Sticky Moloch in this case. Here we go. Oh, it's proper. Oh, goodbye. It actually just looks like a bird. It's like an Archaeopteryx sort of thing. I wonder if it is actually a. I wonder if it's a hybrid. I wonder if it's just an actual existing bird. They're just starting to grow to full size. I decided to go get a few more in here, and there they are. That is a fully grown Claridon. I was hoping they kind of spawned in different colors, and it's a bit of a shame that they don't. You're just floating, doing your thing. But yeah, there you go. That's the Claridons. You can have tons of them in here. I think it's really cool that they give you this base, and then what you can do if you wanted to is hop into creative and then just make the aviary your own. And the problem is really, I say problem. It's a good thing and a bad thing. If we hop out of here, stay. If we hop out of here, you can see it's really not connected to the park at all. So that would be something we need to do. If we want this aviary to be part of the development, we could even have like a little hope of one here, then we need to connect together ourselves in creative mode, because I don't think you can really do it otherwise, but still, I think that's pretty cool. Right, many more still to go. Many more. Let me have a little think here. Right, we have, as far as I can tell, 4 more carnivores to take a look at. And because the park isn't really set up and we don't know which carnivores look cool and which ones can live together and all this kind of jazz, I decided to basically create a series of mini exhibits down here on the beach. Nothing too exciting, of course, but the point is really just to take a look at these dinosaurs, see what they look like, let them grow up, and then kind of decide where they're going to fit into the park later on. I think at some point what we'll do is we'll clear out the entire park and we'll try to design it and have every single creature in here in some form. So let's check out these 4 carnivorous hybrids. The first one up is the Pluma Raptor. I'm expecting a feathery raptor. Oh, it is indeed a... I wonder if it's colored by the sand. That's an interesting idea. I'm just gonna try that out. I'm still in creative mode. Let me just nip over here. I'm just gonna build a little mini thing to contain it. Crossbow, go away for a sec. Okay, we're just gonna build a little thing, and we can train the Pluma Raptor as well. So that's gonna be really cool. We'll have to give that a go. And another one we can train as well. I can't remember what it was though. Anyways, tiny little thing. I just want to put one down to see what happens. Okay, never mind. We're going to have to kill you. You can say that. Do you think? Okay, so that's the Pluma Raptor. Let's get rid of that. Let's go try out the other 3. We have Phasinonathus. This is our Compsognathus hybrid, so should be pretty tiny. It's a fish. I was not expecting a fish. Wow, okay. I'm gonna kill you, buddy. I know that's sad. Oh, no, it's so sad. I'm going to keep those. We're going to add those with the Placidosaur and go make our little... And maybe the Iacus. Do we have lots of... No. I think it's just these two. They're both aquatic-based. We also have the Armig... Oh, no, it's not dead. It's just knocked out. Okay, that's fine. Oh, my God. You're meant to be dead. I'm going to leave you to do your thing. Right, we have the Omega Rex, which is incredible. It's an Ankylosaurus Tyrannosaurus Rex hybrid. We'll have to come back and check this out when it's fully grown, but that looks pretty cool to me already. Let that grow up a little bit. And then finally, we have our Venatorus, which is our Spinosaurus hybrid. Actually, let's check what it is. Let me just double check on our hybrids. There's so many of them. And Simaco and Sticky are going to live together. That's the idea. Anyways, here we go. Let's try this one out as well. Oh, wow. I wasn't expecting that. Oh, it's 4-legged. I don't know what I was expecting. Are you even carnivorous? I actually don't know. It's very interesting. What am I going to do about this fish? Can you just go back to sleep? I don't know if it is meant to be a fish. It has 4 legs. Is it meant to be both aquatic and non-aquatic? It's very peculiar. Anyways, this is the Pluma Raptor, all fully grown. A little bit on the terrifying side, but I do love the kind of slight Jurassic Park 3-esque nature to it. The colour scheme is very unusual, but, you know, it's got the feathers across the back, across the crest, splaying out from the forearms. That's very much what you'd expect. There's some down there as well. Interesting, just a little hint to realism, I guess, which is not something I ever really expect. So, yeah, it's pretty cool. And there it is. This is the Omega Rex, or Meager Rex, I don't know what you call it, but it's got the actual club tail from an Ankylosaurus. It's got all the knobbly bits, the bony bits, the armor plating, but it's, you know, a big ass Rex, basically. Very, very cool. And it does still look like Godzilla. I really like that. I think that's awesome looking. Yeah, maybe my favorite hybrid so far. Very interesting. They do look a little bit like Godzilla monsters, don't they? Ignoring 1998 Zilla, but there's something about the design that kind of resembles a kaiju you'd see in the Godzilla series anyway. At least these bigger boys. But yeah, pretty interesting dinosaur. I don't know how Well, I was about to say, I don't know whether it's carnivorous or not, and then it just bared these massive fangs, so I'm going to assume it is. Alright, I'm going to leave all of you to it. Bye. Right, so we're going to head back to the main park. We have two more enclosures to do. So this is Gyrosphere Valley, currently sans dinosaur in total. There were some triceratops in here, I'm not really sure what happened to them. But that means it is up to us to entirely populate this with whatever dinosaurs we want, so why not our herbivorous hybrids for now at least. So let's check them out. This is Yakusaurus, which I believe is our sauropod. Yeah, there we go. It looks kind of like a Ankylodocus, a little bit. It looks like a sauropod, but with that armor plating on the back. It's pretty adorable, though. Very excited to see the adult version. We have this Sticky, which is, of course, the Sticky hybrid, which is actually adorable. It looks like a little dragon. I don't know why it looks like a little dragon, but it does. What is in this thing? It's Sticky, Triceratops, and Camel. It looks like Pete the Magic Dragon. Or Puff the Magic Dragon. It looks like Pete. Or did Pete have a dragon? I can't remember. You know the green dragon from that cartoon? I don't know. That's what it looks like. That's adorable! Alright, we're going to get a few of you. There we go. We should have, like, maybe three of those. I'm going to rename Gyrosphere Valley into Hybrid Valley. Huh. Interesting. Gotta love creative mode. Right, the final one then is the Simacosophus, which, if I'm correct, is the third of the dinosaurs in the game, along with the raptor and the plumeraptor, that we can train and actually raise and control. And it is basically a parasaur, a little bit of raptor in there, which I guess is why we can control it. But I'm expecting something Parasaurolophus-esque. It's a parasaur with the stegosaurus plates. That's pretty cool too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. We can actually train one of these. We could have a Simaco following us around, being controlled. I guess it's just that raptor DNA makes them moddable, I suppose. So that's how big the parasaurs get. Not massive, but they are trainable, so that's not surprising. I'm just going to stand next to it and shut up for a second. Just listen to the noise this thing makes. Just wait for it. Just wait for it. There it is! I've been listening to that for like 10 bloody minutes since they grew up. It sounds like it's just got a super wet mouth, basically, and he just goes. If you've ever watched Always Sunny, it kind of sounds like Gale the Snail, I'm just saying. So these two don't grow up that big, the Sticky Moloch in particular, but the sauropods grow to, well, sauropod size. They look a little bit weird, they don't really look like dinosaurs anymore, none of them do. These guys in particular still look like little dragons to me. But it's pretty cool to have a proper full-size sauropod hybrid like this in another game. And it looks better than the Ankylodocus. It's not saying much, but it's true. But yeah, it looks cool. They all look very, near enough all the hybrids are quite dull in colour, which is quite surprising to me. You'd think they would be pushing the colour schemes a little bit more. Maybe there's a way to change their colour? I don't think there is. It's definitely not in the DNA book. We'll have to maybe do some experimentation, but we're not done quite yet. We have one more little exhibit to do. So this is going to be another quick build habitat. You can just see it over here. We're just dropping in from above. And this is our aquarium. So like I say, with many of the others, you can build your own aquarium if you want. Now, I don't know how you're meant to manage the dinosaurs for this one in particular. Maybe there's a way in somewhere. I mean, we can do it because we're in creative. I will say that you are clearly meant to play this mode in creative. I think you play, you know, when you open the park, you want to do that in normal mode, amps up the tension. I think discovering the dinosaurs and making the dinosaurs for the first time all in normal mode. But if you want to actually build your park and develop it and have all these dinosaurs in the park, you're probably going to want to hop into creative at some point in time. Especially today, we're kind of just doing a showcase video. I do plan to spend most of our time in survival. I have no idea how you get in and out of here. Oh! Ah! There, look at that! Oh, that's very cool. Okay, no, I like that. Right, well, we're going to just go hang out in here, aren't we? Because why not? Right, first things first, Fascino Nathus again. Are they okay in here? They're going straight for the surface, and that makes me worried. Maybe... Okay, I think they're fine. I think they're just meant to be like flying fish. They really don't look like a hybrid. They just seem like a flying fish. Let's get a bunch of those. Oh, wait, no, I shouldn't have done that. They grow huge, I forgot. Oh, no, that's too many. Anyways, this is our other one. This is the Placidosaur. I'm just going to go double check this one. It might not be aquatic, genuinely. It's got Stegomorph DNA, turtle DNA. That's two turtle DNA. That's the one that's making me think. Placidosaur, if you're not aquatic, I'm so sorry for this. I really am. It is! It's a turtle! It's actually a turtle. It's just a turtle with a massive mouth. There we go. So that would be our aquarium. So let's go let them grow up and we'll go take a look from the punter point of view, as it were. Here we are. And that's awesome. And this is a quick build, so you can change this out for something else. You can completely change it and customize it how you would want to. I have regrets on these flying fish. This is about to become a very big problem because they do grow absolutely massive. Well, there you go, folks. That is our final creature. This one seems to be a different color, but I can't tell if that's the lighting. It's a little bit odd. It's like a giant flat-shelled turtle with a really derpy look in the mouth. The color is... Oh, that's not. Okay, never mind. No, they're all the same colour, as per usual. Just the lighting. But yeah, it's a big old flat turtle. And it is a big boy turtle. I mean, look at them. They're all just chilling there at the bottom of our little aquarium. Very cool. Right, so that is every single hybrid in this new DLC, as well as the old Visitor Centre, and of course the Indominus Rex paddock as well. I think we've now seen most of what this game has to offer, but that doesn't mean we are finished. For example, there is a little paddock over here. Nothing in there. These little babies have been inside each other for a very long time. I don't know what the hell you're doing. If we head over here, are they still here? Where are they? They're here somewhere. My scientists, my security guards, I should say, are still inside each other. They're just never leaving. It's their life now. I think they're over here. Yep, there. I don't know what's got. Do you need releasing, guys? Do you need some help? Do you want me to get you out? Am I just uncovering your dirty, sordid secrets? I think I should leave them to it. So there's still a lot we can do. We can, like I said, I want to see an Indominus Rex battle an Indoraptor. We'll do that next video. But then we can maybe start to develop the park a little bit. I don't know if there's much else to see in general in terms of little features and little areas on the park. But if you see anything, do let me know either in the comment section down below or you can get hold of me on Twitter, stuff like that. Even if I don't reply, I do read all the tweets and stuff like that. Maybe we can give the Mosasaurus a turtle friend. We can make Main Street more interesting. There's stuff we can do. There's also a little observatory. Kind of a weather station over there. We could go check that out at some point. And there's our little aviary. For now though, folks. T-Rex Kingdom. Very cool. Very cool. For now though, folks. We're going to call it a day. There's the Indominus paddock over there. In case you want to get a good idea of, you know, Visitor Center, Innovation Center, I should say. Visitor Center is, I believe, over there somewhere. Indominus Rex paddock over there. I did, just as a side note, by the way, I did go check out the island over there, just thinking, maybe, just maybe, they threw in like a side B on the sly. No, that's actually the amber mine over there on the east coast. I'm wondering if on the other side there is the other dig site. I haven't found that one yet. I suspect it may be over there as well, but who knows. Either way, thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. If you do want to keep up with this game, there is a playlist linked down below in the description. Yeah, sure, we'll find some cool stuff to do next time. Any suggestions, any ideas, anything you'd like to see, do not hesitate to let me know in the comment section down below. Please do hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. I've been working on this for about 2.5 hours now. And either way, I will see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, so much love, as always. Bye-bye. I just want to time that with the music.